Hi my sweet people, today's video is on this granola that I recently made. It's chocolate banana bread granola, which actually is a banana bread granola but actually added in cocoa powder so it became chocolate. So if you want to know more, then just keep on watching. You'll need rolled oats. Then you'll need a banana, vanilla essence, coconut oil, cinnamon powder, some salt, and brown sugar. So in this recipe, I actually did a few changes from the original recipe. And then I will just let you know which parts I actually changed throughout the video. So you will just need to remove the banana, the peels, and mash the banana in your mixing bowl. Just ensure that you actually mash the bananas to a fine paste, like it's all finely mashed, so that you don't have any clumps later. So just make sure that it's finely mashed, then you are good to go. And then after, once you have mashed the bananas, then you can add in the cinnamon powder. I'm adding the cinnamon powder, and after that you can add in the salt. Just mixing the ingredients as I go, so as until I keep adding, I just keep mixing so that it's mixed properly. And then once after that, you can add in the next item, which will be vanilla essence. Okay, so here is actually where I made some changes. So this part is actually supposed to be maple syrup. It's the same measurements that I added. I switched up the maple syrup to brown sugar because I recently saw a granola recipe using brown sugar and I wanted to know how it would taste. So I actually switched out the maple syrup to brown sugar instead to see how I would feel using brown sugar. It actually turned out not bad, but I think that using the brown sugar didn't really come out as sweet as that it normally did, because this is the second time I'm using this recipe and there was changes, of course, due to some of the ingredients that I changed out. So yeah, then you can add in the coconut oil. And after that, you can add in your rolled oats. So just ensure that you mix everything and the oats are coated with the ingredients. And actually, I wanted to, this after adding the oats is where I decided that I wanted to make it a chocolate base instead of just plain banana bread granola. So since the previous time I already made this, I knew how it tastes, so I just wanted to add in some cocoa powder. So this is the second part where I actually did a change, but normally there is no cocoa powder. I'm just adding in the cocoa powder to make it additional. So it actually did turn out nice, but in this time that I made it, the recipe, the oats actually came out to be not sweet, so it's like really mildly sweet, which some people may like and some people may not like, because granola is nicer when it's sweeter, of course based on individual preference. And I actually did like my granola, but I think it would have been nicer if it was sweeter. But of course, next time I may just add in more brown sugar if I'm going to use brown sugar. But if not, you can just carry on with the maple syrup. And as usual, I'm using the Dutch processed cocoa powder, which is darker than usual. So here I'm just adding around 1/4 a cup and not filled to the brim, so it's not that much. I'm not using that much because it's already dark enough, so I didn't want to do it because I should have added it before, but I made the last minute decision to actually add in this, so that's why I actually added it last. If not, you can add in before that. So it did turn out to be interesting, and I mean, of course, I like to change recipes, you know. Sometimes you can just add in your own ingredient to see how it, of course, depending on how you like to, you know, it tastes after the end result. But I did end up liking it. It's just that it's not as sweet as I would have liked it to. Although I'm not really, for granola, I don't really like it so much sweeter, because then it defeats the purpose of me doing it, because those that you can buy in stores, it's actually super sweet, and I don't really like that, because I don't know, granola to me is just to be like just enough sweetness. So this was a little bit lesser than my preference. So next time I may just add in a bit more, depending. So it's up to you on how you actually want to, you know, customize the recipe. So here, once that is fully mixed, then I'm just gonna grease the pan and just add in the granola to prepare to bake it. So I'm not adding the granolas to the sides because my oven is it's quite small, and also the sides end up getting burned all the time, so I'm just gonna avoid that and just put it in the middle. For baking granola, you need to know that you should, for the whole length of the baking period, you need to remove it around halfway so that you can mix it up and then put it back to bake, because so that it actually cooks evenly on both sides. So you just ensure that around 20 minutes, I did it around 20 minutes for me, and then I just removed it to flip it and mix it around, and then just put it back and bake at the remaining time that you need to. Surprisingly, the taste actually ended up being like a chocolate banana bread taste, you know, in these oats, because of adding the cocoa powder and also the brown sugar. So it ended up becoming like a banana bread itself. So it was a nice choice of changing the recipes and customizing it. So I did like the end result. Of course, if you want, you can just you know, do the recipe that I changed it, and I will definitely, for all my recipes, I actually list the ingredients in the description box. So if you want, you can just take a look there. I'll put in the original recipe ingredients so that if you want, you can just follow that. So here I'm just after baking the full 35 to 40 minutes, I'm just allowing it to cool before I store it in the jar that I normally do. It's a airtight container, it's a glass jar that is from IKEA, and then I'm just keeping it. Normally I will keep it for around 2 weeks, depending on how fast I finish it. So that's all for my video. If you really liked it, do like and subscribe if you haven't. Do look out for my future videos, and see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye guys.
She likes chocolate covered strawberries and wine. She likes notes that say I love you all the time. Roses at your